everybody. Welcome back. We're joined by Fox News Channel's Elizabeth Pran. She is live to discuss, from Atlanta, a solar energy farm. So has this been done before? This is kind of an exciting idea.
This is exciting. This is the first time it's been done in this magnitude. There was a test run in San Antonio in 2009, and what they're doing is they're taking landfills that are being covered up, because after they covered up, they can't be touched at all for almost 30 years. So this company, Republic Services, is going to these landfills, and they're putting over a plastic film. We have some pictures of it. It's green, and then they lay over flexible solar panels. They're about 15 inches wide, they're 18 feet long, and they're flexible so they can adhere to the Earth's surface. And they're saying that every 10 acres of these flexible solar panels produces about 1 megawatt of electricity, which is equivalent to about 150 homes, providing light for about 150 homes. Kimberly?
Very interesting. So this is an idea, obviously, that could catch on and develop kind of some residents people will be interested in, especially with the push for, like, clean energy and the whole green movement. Any interest from developers, you know, the people with the money?
Absolutely. And I spoke with a spokesperson from Republic Services. He says that he has a number of people and developers who are interested in installing these solar panels on their landfills, because there's 100,000 landfills right now as we speak that are covered up, and they're not doing anything with them, and some of them are huge. This landfill in DeKalb County that we're talking about is about 50 acres, and there's only 12 acres right now that they're covering as we speak, but if you can imagine, if they get that whole landfill covered, then that'll be electricity for thousands of homes in Atlanta.
Yeah, now I guess the question is, it seems like such an obvious good idea, because the landfills can't be touched. They have to remain there for an extended period of time. But does it in any way disrupt sort of the normal process of a closed landfill?
Well, that was one of my questions, and that's a really good question. And what I was told is that it does not, because this particular cover, it's fairly lightweight, and they're still able to capture all of that gas that's produced from these landfills. Because as we know, as they shift and as they get older, they produce methane gas to heat homes.
Exactly.
And so I'm told that it's now a dual process. So, I mean, it's a win-win situation. It's just a matter of, like you said, getting those installers and those developers to come in and make all those changes.
Well, I think this is part of the process to get the news out there, the word out there, get developers interested, influx of cash, and there you go. That's the way it works in America. Thank you so much for that update, Elizabeth.
That's right.
Appreciate it. All right.